On the 30th of October, 2015, an audience of nearly 500 people packed into Club Colectiv, located in Bucharest, Romania, to see a performance from a popular local metal band known as Goodbye to Gravity. Club Colectiv first opened its doors in 2013, with the building being a former Soviet shoe factory refitted and repurposed as a nightclub. Goodbye to Gravity was promoting their upcoming album, and thus decided to perform the show for no cost to the audience. Promotions from the band promised potential concertgoers the chance to hear new tracks from their upcoming album, accompanied by a light show and pyrotechnics. At around 8:30 p.m., the crowd began to gather around the stage, and at 9 p.m., Goodbye to Gravity began their show, and concertgoers were enjoying the performance as expected, dancing and drinking in the packed nightclub. At 10:32 p.m., as the band was finishing their performance of one of their songs, they set off several fountain fireworks attached to the pillars at each end of the stage. As the band finished their song and soaked in the applause, the lead singer, a man named Andrei Galut, can be seen staring at one of the pillars, and after the lights were dimmed, he exclaimed, "Something's on fire over here." Believing perhaps that this might have been part of the show, neither the crowd nor the Colectiv staff seemed too urgent to put the fire out. And almost as soon as Andrei called for someone to bring a fire extinguisher, the flames engulfed the ceiling of the club, fueled by the extremely flammable neoprene soundproofing foam that lined the entire ceiling of the club. And as the flames rapidly spread, the building was also quickly filled with toxic smoke. After just 1 minute, the entire club was engulfed in an inferno, as desperate concertgoers fled towards the building's single exit. Only half of the 80-centimeter doorway was open, and a crush soon developed at the exit as the patrons fled for safety. The other side of the door was soon kicked open, which allowed a surge of people to escape through it, easing the crush that had developed on the other side of the doorway. Less than 2 minutes after the fire had started, the roof collapsed on the people inside, showering them with burning materials. Upon seeing the crush that had developed at the doorways, some desperate clubgoers broke through windows and managed to escape with their lives. Emergency services arrived on scene 11 minutes after the fire had started, and by the time the blaze was under control, 27 people were dead, including two members of the band, the guitarists Mihai Alexandru and Vlad Talea. A further 146 people were hospitalized, many in serious condition, with 29 of the victims that were hospitalized still being unidentified 2 days later due to their severe burns. By November 8th, several victims had died in the hospitals, and the death toll had risen to 44, and by the 22nd of November, the death count had risen to 60. Over the following months, several more victims of the fire would succumb to their wounds, and on March 18th, 2016, the fatality count of the fire reached 64, as the final survivor of the blaze that was still hospitalized died from their injuries. Vocalist Andrei Galut, the man who had originally brought attention to the fire as it began, was the only member of Goodbye to Gravity that ultimately survived the incident. An investigation into the fire was launched in the aftermath of the incident, and the cause of the fire was quickly determined to have been the use of outdoor fireworks indoors, in conjunction with the extremely flammable neoprene soundproofing that lined the club. It was found that the club's owners had been aware of the flammable nature of the soundproofing, but they had declined to opt for fire-resistant paneling to save money. They believed that the pinewood pillars that held the paneling in place had been fireproofed sufficiently to mitigate the fire hazard caused by the neoprene soundproofing. Furthermore, the club had no sprinklers, only a single narrow exit, and only one fire extinguisher in the entire building, all of which further contributed to the severity of the inferno. In the immediate aftermath, it was also found that the building had received an operating license, despite the building never being inspected by firefighters, and that at the time of the blaze, the venue had been far over its maximum capacity of 80 people. It was soon discovered that the owners of the club had agreed to the free show only with the stipulation that Goodbye to Gravity would pay the club 500 euros if they did not gather a crowd of at least 400 people. By November 3rd, 2015, protests in the streets of Romania erupted as the outraged people called for the resignation of the Prime Minister, Victor Ponta, who resigned soon after. However, in the months following Ponta's resignation, more political fallout would rock Romania as the hospitalized victims' cause of death were brought to light and investigated further. Many of the victims' families and a number of doctors noticed that many of the victims of the fire died not as a direct result of their injuries, but rather died of cyanobacterial infections. Many of these family members complained that their transfer requests for their family members to receive treatment elsewhere in Europe were systematically ignored and denied, with Romania's health ministry saying repeatedly that the patients here receive care that is as good as they could get in Germany. However, revelations would soon come to light that would prove this statement to be not only false, but also cause a major stir in the Romanian healthcare system. Several doctors and hospital workers approached journalists to blow the whistle about these deaths, stating that the reason for the high rate of infections was due to the disinfectant that the hospitals had used, with one brand in particular, Hexi Pharma's disinfectants, being tested and found to have only a small fraction of the disinfectant concentration advertised on the packaging. Despite these initial findings, the Romanian government refuted that the disinfectants used in Romanian hospitals were, quote, 95% effective. However, after much public outcry, Romanian authorities raided the Hexi Pharma production facility, and more independent testing found that every single one of Hexi's products had been diluted, with the most egregious dilution being a reported 1.2% active ingredient concentration in a product labeled to have an active ingredient concentration of 12%. Following these findings, the health minister of Romania resigned, and much public ire was directed at the owner of Hexi Pharma, a man named Dan Condrea. It was uncovered that Condrea had been purchasing ingredients for the disinfectants through a shell company that he owned, which he then sold to Hexi at 7 times the price purchased by the shell company, which then diluted the products and sold them to hospitals at an inflated price, a price the hospital managers were willing to pay due to the managers accepting bribes from Condrea. Soon after this information had surfaced to the public, on May 22, 2016, Dan Condrea died in a car crash near Bucharest, Romania, driving off the side of a road and into a tree, traveling at 93 miles an hour, in an apparent attempt to end his own life. However, many people saw this death as suspicious, as Condrea potentially could have ousted many of the corrupt individuals within the Romanian healthcare system. Condrea's wife was among these people, describing her husband as, quote, "He was not the type of person to kill himself, rather the type of person to kill someone else," a rather damning characterization of her late husband. These allegations of corruption within the healthcare system had eroded the trust of the Romanian citizens in receiving proper medical care, and ultimately resulted in more investigations into the healthcare system in the country. They further found that many of the country's sole burn ward staff were improperly trained, apathetic, and generally incompetent at their duties, with reports surfacing about the treatment that many of the Colectiv victims received. This included not bathing victims, allowing their wounds to fester, with one video surfacing of a burn victim with maggots wriggling inside their wounds, and the doctors in the burn ward covered the faces of the victims of the Colectiv fire with sheets so that they would not have to look at their disfigured faces. Ultimately, it was determined that at least 13 hospitalized victims of the Colectiv fire lost their lives as a result of the diluted disinfectants and by negligence by hospital staff. If you'd like to know more about this investigation into the corrupt Romanian healthcare system, I'd suggest watching the documentary film Colectiv, which chronicles journalist Cătălin Tolentan's efforts to expose the corruption and reform the healthcare system. I'll put a link to it in the description. The final fatality directly related to the fire was on July 29, 2017, where a concert goer that had attended the show with his girlfriend, who perished in the fire, took his own life. Also in 2017, the owners of Club Colectiv and the pyrotechnics company that supplied the band began several years of litigation, and on May 12, 2022, the court sentenced the mayor of Section 4, where the club was located, to a prison sentence of 4 years, which was reduced from an initial verdict of 8 years and 6 months in prison that was issued in 2019, while the owners of the firework company and Club Colectiv itself were sentenced to 11 and 6 years in prison, respectively. Furthermore, the courts ordered that the owners of the club and fireworks company, including minority investors in the companies, pay compensation to the victims, totaling 36 million euros. Ultimately, this negligence and rampant corruption cost 64 people their lives and has irreparably altered the lives of the survivors for the rest of their lifetimes. Thank you all for watching.